the remaining LSAT flex dates with three sections, and that's it, are February happening now, then April and June. Anybody here taking June? Aiming for June? Yeah. Okay, cool. Maybe. So June LSAT flex is the last one with only the three sections. Starting in August and beyond, as far as we know, indefinitely, they're going to be adding back in that unscored experimental section. It'll be any of logic games, logical reasoning, or reading comp. You won't know which one it is during the exam. It could be first, second, third, or fourth. So you're taking the LSAT February, April, June this year. You've got three scored sections back to back, and you're done. That's it. Those of you who are aiming for June or considering June, it's always a possibility that you may end up wanting to retake or needing to retake in August or beyond, in which case you're going to have to do the four section version with that extra section. If you do the four section version, you will get a break between sections two and three. It'll still be on ProctorU. It'll still be that online format that you're already used to from LawHub, I hope, but you will have that fourth section. So I'm putting some information in the chat about this. A couple of links to LSAC's site, a couple of links to videos I made last week about this. Basically, you've got three sections only until June. After June, meaning August beyond, you've got four sections, but it's still online, still at home, still with ProctorU. Same exact format that you see in LawHub, that you've seen for the digital LSAT, the LSAT Flex. It'll still be the same going forward. What else should I mention? They released the test dates last week for every LSAT for the next year and a half or so. Previously, we'd only known about April. Now we know there's going to be an LSAT in June as we expected. There will not be an LSAT in July. We were all kind of expecting a July LSAT because that's how it was in the past couple of years, but they're going to do it in August instead. So the LSAT is not every single month. It's just almost every single month. So you've got coming up June, August, October, November, then next year, January, February, March, and such. But there's no LSAT in 2021 in July or September or December. But there's never been an LSAT nearly every month, so that's not especially surprising. I should also mention that for August, they're moving it a little bit earlier. It's going to be around the starting the week of August 14th. So it'll be earlier than it would have been otherwise. Last year, it was at the end of August. But this is nice because you take it August 14th, you get your score back probably end of August, and then you can apply at the very beginning when applications open in September. The fourth unscored unknown experimental section can be any of logic games, logical reasoning, or reading comp. And they're using that extra fourth unscored section to test out future LSAT questions. So it could be any question type, but might be logical reasoning, might not. But basically, this is a return to before what it was like before LSAT Flex, where you also would always have some unknown experimental section. And basically you finished the exam and you had two sections of logic games. You know, one of those was real, one was experimental, but you don't know which one it was during the exam. Afterwards, of course, you can go online on forums and such, and people can talk about the general details of, did you have the logic game about monkeys? No? Okay, well, if you had it and I didn't, or vice versa, that means that must have been the fake one and the other one was the real one. But it won't necessarily be logical reasoning. Back in the old days when there were four sections scored, you had two LRs, but going forward, we're going to have only one scored LR, just like you have for LSAT Flex. Let's see, Atus is asking about how much longer would the LSAT with four sections be? Well, you'll have another 35 minutes of solving questions for that extra section, but they're also adding in a break, which I've heard is optional. So between sections two and three, you'll probably get a 10-minute break. It's up to you whether to take it or not, but I'd recommend taking it. Get your chance to go to the bathroom, get your chance to stretch your legs and such. Rather than, you don't want to do four sections back to back. I think that's quite a lot. So the break is between the second and third sections, Natalie. It's not after the third. So you do two sections back to back to get your break, do another two sections back to back, and then you're done. Currently with the LSAT Flex on ProctorU, you get a 60-second countdown in between each section. So section one, 60-second clock starts. section two, 60 seconds, section three, 60 seconds. I wouldn't really call 60 seconds a break because you're not allowed to leave the room. And it's not a whole lot of time to do anything other than to take a few deep breaths. But it's adding in altogether, that extra fourth section is adding in 35 minutes plus approximately 10 minutes. And then if you leave the room and come back, they'll do a quick security check. It won't be as comprehensive as when you start the exam. So allow maybe another 2 minutes for the security check to basically, I guess, re-verify your ID or something like that. Do a quick sweep of the room to make sure everything is secure. There's no banned items or anything. And then you'll restart with the third section. Thanks for tuning into the show. Please subscribe if you haven't done so already to be notified of new episodes as I release them. And feel free to reach out if you need anything at all as you move forward with your prep. I'm happy to help however I can. In the meantime, I wish you all the best and take care.